Majesty looked really divine in her crimson robe, furred with her mind. The Duke of Edinburgh, dignified and neat, sat beside her as Admiral of the fleet. He was there
at the coronation.
I was there
at the coronation.
1,000 guardsmen marching ahead.
A diverse group of musical genres originate from the Caribbean. Popular types of Caribbean music include reggae, salsa, and calypso. The Caribbean islands lie in a chain from the Bahamas in the north to Trinidad and Tobago in the south. Central in the chain are the largest islands of Cuba, Haiti, the Dominican Republic, Jamaica, and Puerto Rico. Most of the Caribbean population are descendants of West African slaves and settlers from Europe, India, and China. The music of the Caribbean differs from island to island, but each kind has its origins in a mixture of African and European influences. African musical influences include syncopations, offbeat accents, and cross rhythms, use of percussion, call and response, and singing styles. Whereas European musical influences include tonal, based in a key harmonies and melodies, as well as the instruments used, the guitars, etc. In this video, we will focus on the fusion genre called calypso music. To begin, calypso is a blend of African, French, Creole, and carnival influences, all of which make up this jazzy Afro-Caribbean dance music. Furthermore, it is important to know that it laid the groundwork for the reggae movement, and I think its influence can still be felt today. Additionally, calypso is credited to have influenced the British black music and movement. Calypso rhythms can be traced back to the arrival of the first African slaves brought to work in the sugar plantations of Trinidad. Forbidden to talk to each other and robbed of all links to family and home, the African slaves began to sing songs. They used calypso, which can be traced back to the West African kaiso, as a means of communication and to mock the slave masters. Trinidad was colonized by the Spanish, received large numbers of French immigrants, and was later ruled by the British. This multicolonial past has greatly impacted the development of calypso in Trinidad. Many early calypsos were sung in a French Creole dialect called the patois. These songs, usually led by one individual called a griot, helped unite the slaves. The griot later became known as the chantual, and today as the calypsonian. Calypso singing competitions held annually at carnival time grew in popularity after the abolition of slavery by the British in the 1830s. It was the French who brought the tradition of carnival to Trinidad. Originally the national dance of the Caribbean, Trinidad and Tobago, calypso is particularly associated with carnival. It has 4/4 time with syncopation, acoustic and bass guitar or band with trumpets, saxophones, electric guitars, drum kit, and Latin percussion. It also often uses 3-beat rhythms with 2 long beats followed by a short beat, including lots of call and response, simple harmony, verse and chorus songs, and topical witty lyrics, often satirical. Furthermore, steel band music originated in Trinidad and Tobago during the 1940s, during wartime. Steel bands often play calypso tunes, but also play folk and classical music. Steel bands are characterized by the instruments, known as pans, which were originally made out of oil drums. Lead instruments, known as tenors or ping-pongs, different sizes of pan including alto, guitar, cello, and bass or booms, a rhythm section for up-tempo numbers, including drums and percussion, for example tambourines and maracas, sticks with ends padded with rubber bands, long notes played by rolling a tremolo effect, complex and exciting rhythms formed by short rhythmic phrases and chords, smooth expressive melodic phrases, syncopation, and simple harmony. The man to be interviewed is the Roaring Lion, a famous calypsonian singer.
Baldwin Roberts came and told me that he would like to sing. I asked Mr. Robert E. what was his name as a calypsonian. He told me he didn't have any. I said, well, I will call you Lord Kitchener.
Kitchen, come go to bed. I have a small comb to scratch your head. And do-do, Kitch, don't make me cry. You know I love you. You're playing shy.
Calypso.
Lord Kitchener, now I'm told that you are really the king of Calypso singers, is that right?
Yes, that's so
true. Sing for us?
Right now.
Yes.
London is the place for
a lot of Calypsonians had songs about London.
London.
And it's no surprise when you consider that after World War II, there was a large-scale migration of Caribbeans to England, including Lord Kitchener himself. In the wake of the war and the height of racial segregation in the U.S., it is easy to understand that London must have seemed like an ideal place to pursue a better life, another American dream, so to speak.
I've been traveling to countries years ago, but this the place I wanted to know. London, that's the place.
Calypso became the most popular in Trinidad and Tobago. This is not only where Lord Kitchener was born, but also Lord Invader, Attila the Hun, and Roaring Lion. Roaring Lion is another major figure in Calypso history. His 65-year career began in the early 30s, where he became famous for the ability to extemporize lyrics on any subject, much like freestyle rapping. This fast-paced and almost conversational vocal style became a major component of Calypso and carried into soca and even reggae music. Calypso is a diverse genre. It can also be slow and laid back.
You must be a composer. Tackling any topic come to hand. You call yourself a true Calypsonian.
At a time, Calypso was so self-referential that it became a source of news that people often relied on. Jumping forward a bit, one of the next big Calypso stars was Harry Belafonte, and he incorporated a bit more crooner in his Calypso. His 1965 album was called Calypso, and it was one of the first to sell a million copies. He has many popular songs that you will probably recognize, including this one, Jump the Line.
And when she dances, oh brother, she's a hurricane in all kinds of weather. Jump in the line, rock your body and time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body and time. Okay.
It was his more commercialized form of Calypso that ushered in its golden era, where Calypso was finally considered a mainstream genre, both in the Caribbean, England, and the Americas. Thus also begins the long and complex history of white appropriation of Caribbean and West African music. Using a heavy chorus effect on guitar was one specific characteristic lifted from African music that you can still hear in any music today. This is Calypso Rose. She played a fundamental role in the 80s to bring back traditional Calypso music.
Islamists at your door, it's guns and bombs and hijack, terrorism on the...
All of its features, the style, its origin, the culture, and its history make Calypso so unique in a standalone genre. I discovered that it's a beautiful type of music that has a joyful rhythm to it, but it's also meaningful and powerful. Moreover, I found it very interesting that a lot of modern songs that I like incorporate Calypso elements. In fact, the rich history of this genre of music is really interesting. Famous for its feel-good sound, the melody of Calypso is fun and carefree, but the message behind it has a different tone, as Calypsonian singers have often used their music to spread a message of hope, freedom, and justice.
And I wonder if you really know how hard it is to present your own guys. So you ought to get an idea, then a good composition with sweet music and proper rendition. After you finish all that, you're still not at ease. You have a demanding audience to please. You are to always come good by public demand to be accepted as a true Calypsonian.